Thanks, everybody. I would like to start out by thanking the search committee. They did a great job. They were wonderful to work with, and in the end, it was a great decision, and I was really proud to work with them. With that, I would like to introduce the best president the university's had in the last 20 years, Dr. Terry Farley.
Welcome to Washburn.
Thank you.
How's it feel?
Great.
How's it feel?
Great.
Yay! Good, good. Well, we're not good at this. We haven't had any practice in about 40 years. But we are excited about this. There were some tremendous candidates that were interested in this job. Some of them very good, some of them excellent candidates for the job. Very difficult decision. I too congratulate the search committee. I see a few of them here this morning. We appreciate their work for helping us get screened down to a person that we think is going to be the right fit at the right time and can bring us to the back to the reputation that we have had for oh so many years. Washburn has a good reputation. That's why you looked at this and decided you wanted to be a candidate. Our reputation has been tremendous for so long that your task now is going to be even more difficult. People will expect you to do more, to take to the next level, to do more exciting things, and we're confident that you will do that. You have some tremendous supporters. Many of those people are here in the room today. I urge you to get to know them. They have done everything that we would ask of someone that was wanting to be involved in athletics with the university and involved in Washburn, and to make this program really special. But the real reason that we're here and that we want to welcome you is because of our students. The student athletes, and indeed they are student athletes. You've been around Division I programs. I've been around those. Division II programs are just really special. And they're special because of the attitudes of the coaches and because of the students. They come wanting to play. They've played all of their lives. They don't want to stop now. They have talent. They are excited. Our fans are excited. And we want to make sure that they have a great experience while they're here at Washburn. And obviously, I don't know much about athletes. It's clear I'm not one. But I do know that one of the keys to success is if you treat your players right, they're going to perform, and they're going to perform to the expectations that we set for them. So we're really excited about you being here to help us make sure that those students have a tremendous experience. We appreciate all of you coming out today. We expect you now, each one of you, to bring 10 people each to the next basketball game that we have here in the arena, and we'll do the rest to fill it up, and it won't take very long before the coach is the one that's filling it up here in town. Thank you for coming out today. Congratulations.
When I called Coach Danny Manning to talk to him about Brett, and he told me that if I hired Brett, I'd be hitting a home run. Why he didn't say slam dunk, I'm not sure. But I think either metaphor is appropriate. 38 years ago, the university made a decision to hire a coach, and 38 years later, I would think that they thought that they made a good decision. 38 years from now, when Dr. Farley's here introducing the next coach, we'll say the same thing. We made a great decision. With that, it's a pleasure and honor for me to introduce the next head men's basketball coach at Washburn University, Brett Ballard.
First of all, I want to thank everybody for coming out. I cannot begin to explain how excited me and my family are to be here and have this opportunity. This is a dream situation for us for a number of reasons. And I feel like Dr. Farley kind of wrote my speech because some of the things he hit upon is why I want to be here. When you start looking at Washburn, incredible leadership, great facilities, as you can see, great support, and over time, a great tradition of basketball. And this is a basketball state, and this has been a basketball city. So for those reasons alone, this is a job I wanted to have. But Dr. Farley hit upon it as well. The thing that made this place to me elite and special was the fact that we want to win basketball games, and you guys will find out I'm as competitive as anybody out there, and we're going to do that at a high level. But for me, it's much bigger than that. And I'm here as a coach to impact lives. And that goes well beyond wins and losses on a basketball court. It's my job to help influence these young men for the next 20, 30, 40, 50 years of their lives. And that's why I do this. So the fact that Washburn prioritizes that and makes sure these young men are prepared to go be great husbands, great fathers, great contributors to society beyond this place is why I want to be here. You start looking at jobs and you start putting pieces of the puzzle together on why you want to take a certain job. This one fit every single one for my family and myself. I want to be an elite place that wants to win at a high level, and clearly there's a commitment here to do that. And like I said, I'm humbled, I'm honored, and I'm excited to get to work here. I cannot wait to see you guys out here. I can't wait to get to work. A little bit about myself, and this will be the foundation of who our program is, because this is who I am. The first thing I believe in is work ethic. I've been taught that for a long time. In my family, there's a 90% chance you're either a teacher or you're a farmer. And I've learned from a young age that successful people usually put in work. The harder you work, the more successful you are. So we will work extremely hard to make sure we're successful. And that's been ingrained in me since I was little. I don't believe in making excuses. I met with our guys last night, and I told them we will not make excuses. I believe people that are successful figure out a way to get things done. So we will not make excuses. We will figure out a way to be successful and to help these young men do what they got to do. Character, really big on character. And again, that's been taught to me from a young age. How you treat people. We will treat people the right way. I will treat people the right way. I believe in treating people, whether they can help you or not help you, there's a certain way you act with people. For me, a lot of it becomes with my kids. I want to be an example to them as a father on how I want them raised and how I want them to act when they get older. And we'll carry that over to our players. But we will treat people and act the right way. I believe and I got this from Coach Williams, and I see Wayne Simeon back there. He heard this a bunch. I believe in enjoying the journey. Coach Williams would say that all the time, enjoy the journey. I think you can't go through life just wishing for the next big thing or working for the weekend or waiting for the big game. I think you miss so many opportunities to enjoy things along the way. We will embrace the process. We're going to have fun together. There's a lot of stress that goes with this job and a lot of stress that goes on these young men. So we have to find a way to enjoy it and have fun, and we'll do that. I want them to be enthusiastic, I'll be enthusiastic, and we're going to enjoy the process of getting better together. And then the last part of about it for me, and they're over here, is my family. And we will be a family at Washburn Basketball. I told the guys that last night. We're going to do everything as a family. Families respect each other. Families don't always get along. Sometimes you have issues with somebody in your family. But we will respect each other. We will do everything together. And this will be a family mindset and a family atmosphere with those guys and everybody involved with our program. I want to thank a few people that are here and some that aren't here, but first I'll start with my family. I use the hashtag when I tweet sometimes, Team Ballard, and we really are a team. One of the things that I did when I submitted my resume is I put a picture of my family in with my resume, and I wanted to show the committee what a great recruiter I was, and that I could recruit at a five-star level. And that is our head coach at home, and that is my wife, Kelly. Ballard, Kelly, stand up, please. She Being a coach's wife is not easy, and she's unbelievable. She's my best friend. She handles everything. I don't have a clue what's going on behind the scenes, but she takes care of everything, and she's amazing. The next two people I'll introduce is my boys. Now this is the most dressed up you'll ever see these guys. They will never dress up like this again. They have basketball shorts in my office. They'll be in basketball shorts about 20 minutes after this is over. But they will be around all the time, and I'm excited the fact that they're going to get to run around, and you'll see them in every game. But Caden is 10. Stand up, Caden. And then Brooks is 7. And last but not least is our littlest one, Bregan. She's Miss Happy-Go-Lucky. She will be dressed up quite a bit, won't you? You like to dress up? And she's been our pride and joy, but she'll be around too, and that's my daughter, Bregan. The next people I want to thank are Dr. Farley and Mr. Ferre. I thank you guys for this opportunity. I know what a privilege, like I said, an honor, and what it means to be the basketball coach here is, and I won't take that lightly. I also want to thank the committee members. I know they had a tough decision to make. A lot of really big-time people try to get this job, and that says a lot about what you guys have done here. But I know the committee and everybody involved had a tough decision. I want to thank everybody for their time and commitment to that, and I appreciate you guys giving me this opportunity. The next people I want to thank is our current players, and we've got some of those guys here. I told them in the team meeting last night, I was really proud of them, how they've handled this transition from afar, from what everybody's told me. Because when you go through a coaching change, that's really, really hard on those guys. Really hard. It's a tough situation. The entire year's tough on them, knowing you're not going to have that coach again. And also just with the transition of a new guy coming in, it's easy to let some things slip. But from what everybody's told me, they've handled it well. They represent this university at a high level. And I want to thank them for coming today, but also for, you know, again, just in front of everybody, how you guys have handled the situation so far and taking care of your business. Dr. Farley said this, but this is about you guys. This press conference is about me, but after today, it's not about me. It's about you guys. It's about making sure we do what we got to do to help you guys be successful. And I told them we will give them everything they need to compete at a high level. But if I give them everything they need as a coach, I will have very, very high expectations for our players. And I know they're up for it. I'm excited about the group we got coming back. We got a really good nucleus of guys, and I know they're hungry to get after and get started. And I thank those guys for everything that they've done so far. The next person I want to thank is Coach Chipman. It's been said, but I know the court's getting named after him. I'm going to see if they can put that in 12-point font in the very corner. Not because I don't have respect for Coach Chipman, but because I don't want to look down there and look, okay, I'm only 770 victories away from passing him every time I walk on the court. Coach Chipman, to win 800 games is phenomenal, and the level that he won at over time here is really impressive, and quite honestly, it puts pressure on the next guy that comes in, because that's not easy to do. And I've respected Coach from afar for a long time, worked with him a little bit. I look forward to get to know him a little bit better in the future, but I want to thank him for everything he did for this city, for this university, and for this program over time. I'm a big fan of his, and he will be respected moving forward. Next people I want to acknowledge are the former players. On the committee, Jordan Canfield and Gary Cushenberry, two former players, are on the committee that interviewed with me. And you could feel the passion those guys had for this program. I mean, you could just feel it. Those guys were intense in a good way about their commitment and what this place meant to them. And so for me, that was great to see. When I got accepted for this job, I got messages from Kansas players. I got messages from Adonis Jordan. I got messages from Jock Vaughn. I got messages from Wayne Simeon. I got messages from Tyrell Reed. And some of those guys, Adonis Jordan, Jock Vaughn, I never played with and hardly even know. But I think the special thing when you play at a place like Kansas is it's a brotherhood. And regardless if they know you or don't know you or played with you or you coached them or not, everybody's happy when one of theirs is successful. And I think we have that here, but I want the former players to know we're going to continue to build on that. This is your program. Regardless of what coach you played for, this is your program. You know, I know a lot of the guys obviously played for Coach Chipman, but they're welcome to come back. I want our guys to feel and see the passion the former players have for this place, and former players will be a big part of what we do. We'll reach out to them. I want them around practices, games. We need them back in supporting our program, and I want to thank them for all the commitment they've made over time to this program. I want to thank my mentors in coaching, and I could go a long ways down because I've had great coaches at every level along the way. I had great youth coaches. I had an unbelievable high school coach, junior college coach, but you know, particularly I want to thank Coach Williams. You know, Coach Williams gave me an opportunity to walk on at Kansas, and without that opportunity, I wouldn't be standing here in front of you guys today. And he treated me just like he treated Wayne Simien or Drew Gooden or Kirk Heinrich, and I always respected that. There's a reason why the guy just won a national championship a week ago, and you know, to this day, he treats me great, and I want to thank him for everything he taught me as a player. Bill Self. Coach Self, I was fortunate enough to work with him for 7 years, and as good of a person as he is a coach, treats people the right way, does things the right way, committed to the program every day, committed to the players every day, and I learned from him how you run a program from top to bottom, and obviously he's had a little success over there. The bad part about Coach Self is, I remember at Baker I won 23 games, which was a really good year. It was the third most wins in school history, and I was feeling great about it. And I'd go talk to KU people about it. They'd say, hey, how was your year? I said, good, we won 23 games. I go, ooh, it's tough. And I said, what's tough? He goes, well, yeah, Kansas, we win 31, 32, 33 games every year. So I'm going to see if Coach Self can dial it back for a few years, take a little of the pressure off of me. But that guy's been a great mentor to me. We talk all the time, and I look forward to, you know, kind of reconnecting with him, being back in the area. Last person I want to thank from a mentor standpoint is Coach Manning. Danny and I started working together at Kansas, and I've told this story a little bit, but he was coming off a 15-year NBA career. I was coming off scoring 59 total points at Kansas. So similar deals. Similar pay. I think we're getting paid about the same, too. So he comes in, and I come in. I remember I watched Danny growing up. I mean, that was my guy. I was at the parade in 88 when they won the championship. I mean, Danny Manning. So I'm like, God, I wonder what this guy's going to be like to work with. And I was worried about it. And from day one, thing I learned about Coach Manning, he treated me like I was one of his sons. And that's just how he's been to me. And we were together over 10 years at Tulsa and then at Wake Forest, hooking back up. I've learned so much from him on so many different levels. The guy's very bright in everything he does. And we had a good year at Wake Forest last year, so I'm really excited about what they're doing there. And it made it a tough decision to come here because of that. But Coach Manning is another guy I want to thank, and for everything. Him and Julie have been terrific to me and my family. Next people I want to acknowledge are the professors and the faculty here. You know, like I said, my father's a teacher. My father's getting ready to retire this year after 45 years of teaching. My sister is a teacher. My mother-in-law was a teacher. I've got aunts and uncles. I got 20 plus teachers in my family. So nobody, and my degree was in education, nobody will respect more what the professors and faculty members do here than I will as a coach. Educators are, to me, the most important people we have in our society. So I want to thank them for what they've done for our young men to this point, and I want them to know, everybody on campus, we're here to help them. I'm here as a coach to help them, to help these guys make sure they earn their degrees and do what they got to do to get that done and be successful in the classroom. And I'll finish with this to our fans and to our boosters. I know we're going to have a little meet and greet later, but to the fans and to the boosters, Dr. Farley's right. Lauren's right. We need your support. We need your support. We cannot do this without the support of everybody in this room and outside of this room, our fans and our boosters. We need to win at a high level in this day and age of every level of college athletics. You have to have support. That's people in the seats, and that's financial support, and that's support for our players. And so I encourage everybody in the area to come out. I think you're going to be excited about what you see, excited to support these young men, because we're going to compete and play at a high level. But also just know I'm here for you. you will have access to our program. We'll have a lot of stuff social media wise. We'll have a lot of stuff that I want the people in this area and the people in the city to feel like this is their program. When the people in Topeka think of a basketball program, I love Kansas State, you know, I don't love them as much, but I get it. When they think of basketball, the first thing I want them to think is this. And I want that to be the mindset of the people in this area. And a lot of that's on us, but I want them to know that we'll be here for them, to connect with them, and be available. Like I said at the start, I'm so excited about being here. This is a dream come true. Excited to get to meet a lot of people in this room. I thank you guys already for the support you're going to give us, the support you're giving these young men, and I'm ready to get to work very quickly. So go Bods.
Before you open up for questions.
Oh, nice. Thank you. I gotta wear this?
Yeah.
It's the right number. I guess we're going to open up for questions, Gene?
Yes.
Who's first?
Brett, you mentioned you moving in here. Kind of go through what you're going to be doing here in the next few months. When does the family come and that sort of thing?
If anybody has a cheap house for sale, with five bedrooms and it's been a whirlwind, Kevin. You know, so we got our house on the market in North Carolina. I'll be here. Luckily, the kids are on spring break this week, so the family's here. They'll be here for a few more days. The wife is going to start looking for some places here in Topeka soon, and then they'll come out. They don't get out of school there till June 10th, so it'll be a little bit of time before they actually come out. But I'll be here. I got to go back and forth a couple times just to keep my eye on the boys, I'll be here and start to work. You know, we'll start right away. Recruiting will be a priority, and our players will be the top two things that we'll focus on amongst a lot of other things. Got to get camps going. Got to get organized on a lot of things. But I'll be here starting now, pretty much until the family gets here.
What's the biggest difference? You had the 2 years running your program at Baker, and you've been an assistant most of the other time. What are the differences there, and you think maybe now at this point in your career you're even more ready for this type of role?
As far as the difference between being an assistant and being a head coach?
Sure.
a lot more pressure. You sleep a lot better at night as assistant coach. But, Matt, a lot of people thought I was crazy to leave Kansas to take the Baker job. It was the two best years of my life. And it was the toughest decision I've ever had to make, to leave there to go with Danny to Tulsa. So that experience was, I can't put a price tag on it, it was invaluable. There's a lot of differences. I think the biggest thing is, as a head coach, you've got to navigate 100 different choices every day. As an assistant, a lot of times you focus in on 3 or 4 or 5 things. And as a head coach, ultimately the decisions come down to you. So, you have to, evaluate situations and then make decisions and then prioritize things based off of what's important. But just the amount of decision making is a lot different. And I do think that experience being there is huge. Now, I've told the committee this. I want to be a lot better coach 10 years from now than I am now, and 20 years. And I think that's what the Bill Selfs, the Mike Krzyzewskis, the Williams of the world do. They keep getting better and growing. I think the second I get stagnant, the second the game will pass you up. So I got a lot of growth and a lot of learning still to do. But I do feel like that experience, and even being with Coach Manning another 5 years, being in the ACC, all those experiences add up, and I think will be beneficial here.
How do you go about getting Topeka behind you, like you mentioned?
Well, I think this is the obvious answer, but you got to win. People want to support winners. So the first thing we got to do is handle our end of the bargain. We got to win. I think the people in this area know basketball, so they want to see a team that competes and plays the right way. These are knowledgeable people, knowledgeable fans, so they want to see a team that's playing the right way, playing for each other, and competing the right way. So I think that's important. And then a lot of it's on me. You know, I got to be available and accessible to the public, and that'll happen. Being out, meeting people, restaurants, different events. I got to make sure they feel a connection through that. And then another area is through our camps. You know, through the youth programs here, we'll have a presence with the youth programs. It's perfect for me because my boys are going to be playing anyways, so I want to be around that. But we'll have a presence with the youth in this community, so hopefully they grow up around Washburn basketball and being fans of ours.
KU's had so many guys come over and work camps and stuff for Coach Chipman and throughout the years. Do you think maybe even a bigger connection now, or is that possible?
Well, I hope so. You know, that's good for us to have those guys come over. You know, I know they're popular over here, and I think that's great for the kids to get to see the Vontae Grahams of the world. That's pretty cool for these kids, people they see on TV. So, we'll try to have that relationship clearly with KU, and hopefully that'll be it's beneficial both ways, you know, because those guys get paid to come work camp. So I think it's beneficial both ways, and I look forward to continue to have that relationship with those guys.
Did you check the schedule to make sure when you and Coach Self will face off in that before you said yes?
We don't play them this year, so I got a year to prepare myself. It's going to be weird being on the other sideline. I'm sure I'll get a really warm welcome, and they'll be cheering for us. But no, it's going to be. I won't lie to you, man. I've thought about that a little bit. How cool that's going to be, and you know that's down the line. We got a lot of work to do before then. But for me, a Kansas kid, you know, I've been on all levels of that. I was at the Kentucky game in 1989 when they won 155-95 as a fan. Then I got to play at Kansas. Then I got to coach at Kansas, and now I get to coach against Kansas, which I don't know if that was really on my bucket list of things to do. It's sort of surreal that I've sort of been on all different facets of it.
Brent, most of the time when a coach steps into a new situation, it's kind of a rebuilding project. But mm-hmm. This team, you know, they return most of the experience and pretty much all their starters. How much of an asset, you know, is that to have that returning experience?
Well, I think it's great, and they got a really good group coming back, and they had a really solid year last year. So I think in a lot of ways it's positive. But I've also seen the flip side of that. I was there when Coach Self took over for Coach Williams. And, you know, Wayne can attest to this. So we were coming off back-to-back Final Fours at Kansas with Coach Williams. He left for Carolina. Bill Self comes in. And it was a challenge. We had a good team, but it was a challenge because it was different. It was different for those guys, different philosophy, different mindset, different approach. And like I told our guys this in a meeting last night, change is hard, really hard. And I can even relate the first year I went to Baker. It was different on those guys. And I told them and I told the committee, and I won't hide the fact, we are going to do things to a certain level and I have a certain standard. And we're not going to shortcut things so that we may win a game or two extra this first year, because that jeopardizes the culture and the mindset of your programs in year 3, 4, 5, and 6. So trust me, these guys are ready and I think they're going to buy in, and I believe we're going to have a really good year. But that change can be hard. And it's not always a seamless transition to just start winning right away for the new guy. If people would have judged Bill Self after his first 2 years at Kansas, there probably would have been a lot of people saying, I don't know. And now you look back and it's almost comical. So, you know, sometimes it takes a little time. And I told the guys, the sooner they buy in, the sooner they get 2 feet in the circle, the sooner we can take off and have success. But again, that's a challenge, and we'll work through that. A lot of that's relationships. They've got to learn to trust me. I can't lead them until they trust me. And I've got to build that through my relationship with those guys. But I am excited. We got some good guys coming back, some good players coming back. The coaches have told me good things about the young guys too. So I think we can get step in and get it rolling pretty quickly.
What can people expect from a style of play standpoint, and what kind of emphasis do you put on that?
Well, I want to be efficient on both ends of the court. I mean, we'll be great defensively. To me, you know, defense is what's going to, you know, most of it travels. Defense travels. Sometimes you don't make jump shots, but defensively we'll be great, and we'll compete every night on defensive end. But don't get me wrong, we're going to be good offensively and efficient offensively. I told the guys this last night, but everybody wants to play fast. And I played for Coach Williams, who plays as fast as anybody in the country. That's not easy to do. So we will play up tempo, and I want to play up tempo as long as we're efficient. As far as what we're going to run and the exact details of everything, that's still a little bit up in the air, because I'll tweak that according to our personnel. But I do think we'll play an up-tempo, fun style. We were third in the ACC in scoring this year, so it's been great for me to be with Coach Manning and our mindset and the way we could score the ball. And we had really good players, but we want to get up and down and score some points, but it's hard to score a lot of points. I told the guys this: if you're taking the ball out of the basket every time, if you don't get any stops, you can't play fast. So we got to get to stops defensively, and then we'll get out and run.
What was the biggest thing you learned from your time at Baker that you were able to kind of take into this situation, do you think?
It's a lot of things, and it's hard to really pinpoint. I learn something every day. But I think a few things. I started to realize how important a relationship with your players is as a head coach, and making sure in this generation, players want to know the why. They want to know why you're doing things. It used to be you could kind of just tell guys what to do and they do it. And we'll have standards, and there'll be things we're going to do, but we're going to explain to them why we're doing things and why, and there's a process to it. And I think that part of it was important for me to learn from a head coaching perspective. Delegation, you can't, as a head coach, you've got too many decisions. You have to make sure you delegate things the right way. But even in-game preparation, how you handle officials, everything, I learned something, like I said, every day.
Okey-doke.
Easy enough.
We'll set up for some. Thank you.